All right. You already know what's going on, man. It's cold, I'm back. Before I get into this video, I got these shirts. These cool shirts that I made. They're coming out real soon, this weekend, October 2nd, 2021. If you wanna learn more about these shirts, if you wanna cop one, because they're pretty cool. I got these and I got short sleeves too. They're real comfortable, they're real swaggy. Little print right here. It's mirrored, so I couldn't figure out which side. Anyway, that's not what we're here to talk about. If you wanna learn more about these shirts, Instagram in the description. We're here to talk about the race war that's going on Twitter right now. It's kind of over now, but it's still kind of going on. As you can see, the retweets are still refreshing every so often. Basically, what happened was this TikTok went viral. And this is the TikTok, and this person, Mr. Scully, said, "I know it smells crazy in there." This is the tweet.
When that one song comes on in the club.
And it's hilarious because yo, he is happy. Yo, dude in the black shirt is happy. This is so great to I love seeing people like happy like this. It's funny though because that song is like their gin and juice. When that shit comes on, it goes up. I'm telling you, it goes up. Mr. Scully here as a joke. Very harsh joke. Racist joke, sure. Says, "I know it smells crazy in there." That tweet set off a whole heap of fucking tweets like this one here from Miss. Her name, I don't want to butcher your name, so I'm not even gonna try to pronounce it. Even though you're, kind of racist and shit, I'm gonna be respectful to your name and not try to butcher this shit. But she says, "I promise you, we smell better than you lazy blacks. Y'all literally descended from gorillas, and they eat their own shit." So let's break. There's so many tweets like this, and they're funny to me, 'cause like I don't know. Is she saying that we smell bad because we're lazy? Because like we don't take the effort to shower? Is that what it is? I mean, we have so many like negative stereotypes. Lazy, deadbeats, can't swim. I can't swim. Welfare. Well, we have so many things. I never heard that black people smell bad. I don't know. Y'all are literally descended from gorillas and they eat their own shit. I don't know if she knows how evolution works, because we're not literally descended from gorillas. I guess she's just trying to be mean. But it's hilarious. Yeah, I don't think this is funny. I think this shit is hilarious. I feel like, though, if pressed in person, she wouldn't keep the same energy. That's just my hypothesis on the whole situation. And then we got this tweet here. Blah 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 blah. Niggers. Blah 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 blah. As so translated by Google, it says, "I'm tired of niggers. Niggers supreme Indian for all monkeys." I'm not sure. Obviously that was a rough translation. I'm sure that's not what he actually meant to say. But if it is, Indian for all monkeys is hilarious. Indian for all monkeys. This gentleman, Gurjeet, says, "You niggers are dirty apes. You deserve to go back to the cotton field slave. I will rape your girlfriend too." Not my girlfriend. I will. If you even look at her crazy, I'm. "Don't speak bad on my India." I mean, I get that he felt personally attacked by that tweet. It wasn't really an attack on India. It was just a joke saying, "I'm sure it smells bad in there." You're just assuming he was saying it because of it being Indians in there. I'm sure that's what the joke was. Don't get me wrong, but you kind of are assuming that. He could have just been like, "Oh, you guys have just been dancing all night. It smells bad in there." "I will rape your girlfriend too" is crazy. Like to go from like, "Yo, it smells bad in there," to like, "I will rape your girlfriend." How dare you say I smell? I will rape. "I know it smelled like shit and piss when you four slave monkey niggers were getting transported for five doubloons in the 1500s." Five doubloons is crazy.
This one's actually, like, funny. The other ones were just, like, trying to be harsh on purpose. But this one's... Five doubloons is kind of funny. I'm not gonna lie. And I'm sure it did smell bad on those boats. I'm sure it smelled like shit and piss and vomit. I'm sure it smelled like all of those things. I feel like, personally, which is the point of me making this video, I feel like they, and I don't mean, like, they as in Indian people. I just mean, like, racist Indian people who already had prejudice. I feel like they have been waiting for something to happen to where they can involve themselves in the black community. I've seen messages like, fuck Black Lives Matter. I've seen, like, George Floyd slander. I've seen a bunch of stupid shit. I have, like, the thread pulled up here. This video right here. I know it's an old Vine, but someone, like, put it back out here. Fucking hilarious.
I do not associate with niggers.
I don't associate with niggers is hilarious, bro.
How do you not find joy
in his bright smile as he says niggers for hundreds and thousands and millions of people to fucking see?
I do not associate with niggers.
And it's funny because I believe he doesn't actually associate with niggers. I really believe that he does not like black people. I don't feel like recropping this shit. Let's see. But if I called you tree swinging baboon, Black Lives Matter would be knocking at my door. I mean, probably. That's a little more harsh than you smell bad. Let me see. I don't feel like recropping it, so you're just gonna have to take my word for what these things say. I swear to God, I've been nice to all my black customers in my fried chicken shop, despite trembling in fear that these dark baboon niggers might rob me or try to sell me drugs. Why would you be afraid someone trying to sell you drugs? Like, that's not anything to be afraid of. Like, hey, yo, you want some weed? Oh my God! Oh! Weed! Oh! You want some cocaine? Oh, coke! Oh, please don't sell me drugs. You wouldn't be why would you be afraid of that? It all ends today. Fuck all you nappy headed monkeys. I hope all your rap careers fail and the police raid you. Like, the thing is, like, regardless of this tweet, the tweet of the dude saying I bet it smells bad in there, you were thinking this the whole entire time. Like, you were you just weren't vocalizing it. Like, you said it yourself. Like, you tried to be nice to all your black customers in your fried chicken shop, which I'm sure is not... I don't think this man really owns a fried chicken shop, but it's crazy because a lot of your people come into my people's neighborhood and capitalize off of us so that you could feed your families, but you actually hate us, which is crazy. That's another conversation for another time, though. This one, I know it smells crazy in there. And then a picture of this, as if every black... I mean, I look good, bro. Mercery tees, feel me? Hit my Instagram. Black Lives Matter. What about... Mind you, this nigga didn't say nothing about Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter, ? Like, whoa, Black Lives Matter? I know you didn't say anything about Black Lives Matter, but Black Lives Matter... What about Asian lives? Fucking gorilla. Looks like you stuffed pounded yam up your nose, you nigger. With the star over the eye because he doesn't want to be explicit. You know, he wants to censor himself. Maybe the star stands for O, like nagger. Like, noggin. Like, you think a lot. You are a nagger. I don't know. But that's how they be feeling, bro. I feel like they be feeling like this and they just wait for a reason. One thing about blackies is crazy, is they will be racist and y'all allow it. I'm so tired of this bullshit. This is why I never respect their wishes of not saying the N-word and fuck BLM. I mean, hey, if you want to go ahead and say it, I just say it to one of us. Like, don't say it in secrecy. Say it to me. If you watch this video, whoever typed this tweet, like, hit me up on Instagram link in the description. Hit me up on Instagram and then we can set up you saying this to me. Because if you don't respect my wishes of not saying it, cool. Don't.
Say it. Say it all you want, but just like meet up with me and say it to me. That's the thing, like, you guys are closet racists, a lot of you. And, you know, it'd be cool if you just said it to me. Well, maybe if blacks spent less time behind bars and in their local Popeyes, they get a chance to attend a fun party that doesn't get shut up, by the way. That party did not look fun. There was no women on that dance floor. If that was fun to you, niggas was dancing with their arms up like this. I mean, look, they looked like they was happy. I'm sure it was fun to them. Their local Popeyes. The local Popeyes that Indian people work at, by the way. How dare you speak, you jungle monkey. You swarthy, smelly, night-skinned nigger. How dare you open your fat-rimmed, encrusted, menthol-smoking mouth to speak of the affairs of a beacon of civilization, the Republic of India? You are monkey. Indian Army will K1LL you apes by the bushel. Pongo is her name. Pongo. I was driving past the lake and I looked and then it disappeared. And I wondered to myself, where'd the pond go?
That was bad.
That was bad. Pongo. Listen, any person named Pongo can't tell me shit. If that's even, I'm just assuming that it's your name because it's your display name. It could just be like a word that I don't know the meaning of. But anybody named Pongo, I'm not taking seriously. Your name is Pongo. Derek Chauvin is our hero from India. We stand with our Aryan brothers. It's crazy because that's another thing about that culture. They like love white people and white people don't fucking like them. Like they will be racist towards black people, but like cool with white people when white people harm them more than black people do. All in all, I think that this is crazy. I think that all these tweets, for the most part, are just pent-up things that they felt already, and they just needed a reason. And they finally got a reason to say what they want to say. That's what it is. But, like, in all honesty, though, when that one song comes, this party do look fun. Like, was he just... Nah. The nigga in the white shirt was just jerking. He's jerking. I haven't seen a nigga jerk in a party. Pause. Not a woman in sight. Not a woman in... For there to be not a woman in sight, I know it smelled crazy. It had to smell crazy in there because no women was on the dance floor dancing with y'all. You would think one woman would be like, all right, let me dance with these dudes. Nah. They wasn't with it. Pongo was like, I'm not dancing with y'all. It smelled terrible. And look at these. They all look like rapists. They all look like they'll rape your sister. You're not telling me that this dude right here, this one right here in the middle with the flowery shirt, don't look like a rapist. He look like he's ready to call someone a mother child and rape him. And this one almost bumped over that nigga. All right, man. I don't know. That's my video. Like I said, again, if you want to film me, if you want to cop one of these joints this weekend, hit my Instagram. Hit my Instagram. Link in the description. And for all the racists out there, I don't want to be friends after this. So let me get this off my chest real early. Suck my dick.